All right, I got your nice Christmas gift. It's a very spiffy hat. Thank you. But who are you?
I told you already. You can call me friend.
Okay, well, what do you want?
I'm a huge fan of yours. Will you do a review, please, please, please?
Well, I don't really know you, and my power's out.
Oh, well, give me a sec. I have complete control of your house, so review. I'll call you back when I finished watching it, okay?
I guess I'm reviewing.
I've always been extremely indifferent to Mrs. Aguilera here, my entire life. I've never thought of her as bad, but if I heard her, I wouldn't exactly jump and scream, "Yay, it's Christina Aguilera!"
Plus, she's made a lot of less than stellar guest appearances. You wanna know how to make me smile? Take control on me just for the night. Well, if I share my secret, you're gonna have to keep it. Night is glowing, I'll be in my castle golden. But until the gates are open, I just wanna feel this moment. I just wanna feel this moment. Ooh, I just wanna feel this moment. This worldwide, Christina Aguilera.
Oye, mamita, come on, dale, que la cosa está rica.
Well, she's not that bad, and I just really hope she doesn't repeat history by having a really bad guest appearance with this band, A Great Big World. Before I listened to this song, I thought I'd listen to some of the other Great Big World songs to see, and I gotta say, I'm pretty surprised.
These guys are talented musicians that have songs with decent lyrics and instrumentals that are just so happy you can't help but smile.
I'm actually kind of excited for this song, so let's hear it.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
How did you... Hello? Hello?
Man, this is boring. Listen to another one of their songs. That's fun and actually utilizes his piano talent. Here it just sounds like an exercise right out of a how to play piano book.
I kind of feel like Ian Axel, the pianist, actually hated recording this song.
If you listen to their other songs, Ian Axel is a pretty good pianist and his music just gives you a sense of happiness. But they were probably so desperate for a hit that they sold out, did a slow, lazily made ballad with Christina Aguilera, and he's just hating every second of it.
I mean, look at that face!
Anywhere I'm giving up on you.
You think he's putting emotion into this song? Nope, he's actually thinking, why? What have I done to deserve this? Ugh, this song is so slow and boring. Christina, shut up!
This song is really aggravating because it pulls a lot of cheap tricks to make you think this song is actually sad.
The extremely slow tempo and a music video with a grand piano, all the black imagery and the lack of color or lighting, and the icing of the depression cake. They had a whole old couple with a dying wife to manipulate you into feeling something for a song that's basically a bunch of words mishmashed into a pile of complete nothingness.
Yeah, I said that. Don't believe me? Let's take a look.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Wait, what?
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Run on sentence much?
Commas. Use them.
Seriously, I don't want to listen to a song that sounds like it was written by a middle schooler who didn't proofread his essay.
You could make the argument that it's a couple talking to each other, but there isn't enough context to prove that true. And even if there was, is their conversation so quick that they're saying things so closely together that it sounds like one sentence?
That is a very specific and awkward type of conversation that really isn't justifiable by any of the other lyrics, so there's only really one explanation. Bad writing! Okay. Maybe I'm wrong. Let's listen to the rest of it.
I'll be the one if you want me to.
You'll be the one what?
Anywhere I would have followed you.
Follow who, where, and why?
Say something, I'm giving up on you. And I am feeling so small. Over my head, I know nothing at all, and
what's going on here? I'm rushing. Let's keep going.
Okay, so somebody's regretting something. Doesn't say who, or why, or even specify whether it's the boy or the girl.
We'll swallow my pride. You're the one that I love, and I'm saying goodbye.
He or she swallows his pride, and he or she still loves the other. And it ends.
That was about nothing!
It was just a random assortment of regretful love stereotype lines smashed together over a melodramatic video so that they can manipulate you into thinking it was an emotional song.
Not only is the song really manipulative, it's not even structured properly.
As painfully vague as the lyrics are, it's clear that this was only one side of the couple's story. So there's literally, absolutely no reason Christina Aguilera even needs to be here.
It gives me the impression that she just drove up to the studio in the middle of filming and just like invaded the video and nobody stopped her.
I would have followed you.
They both sing pretty much the same verse at the same time, and she doesn't add to the story of the song or add emotion. She doesn't do anything but double the amount of voices saying that stupid line.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Ugh. Well, you're probably thinking to yourself, Mala Kritiko, isn't that what a guest appearance is? Two people appearing on the same song? At its bare minimum. But if you're only looking for the bare minimum in music, then you should leave, because we're not going to get along.
Look at Gautier's Somebody That I Used to Know. This song has a male and female singer that perform both sides of the story, adding their own input and emotion to add to the song and making it relatable to an even wider audience by not taking sides and actually telling a story about a breakup rather than one person just complaining about one.
Honestly, I wish this song was complaining.
That would at least make it something. The way it is now is just a big pile of boring, manipulative nothingness.
Wait, there's also something else I'd like to say.
I watched the music video on YouTube, and someone left a comment saying she admired that Christina Aguilera shed tears and saw the real her.
By the oh-so-rare chance this person is watching this video, or if somebody else is watching this video and thinks the exact same thing, in 1988, we had Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
A movie where cartoon characters and real people were on the screen at the same time.
It's almost 30 years later. Do you really think we can't make fake tears? Wait.
The song is designed for one person, but the hook has a line that could possibly be said by two people, but they never perform it like that, so it is a grammatical error, but if you want to justify it like that, you could, because there are two people there, but it's not, the rest of the song isn't designed like that, and
the song is so bad!
It's stupid, it's boring, it's lazy, it's just,
I don't think I've ever really gotten this worked up before, but it's aggravating, okay?
I guess if there's any bright side, a great big world is revealed to the masses and may gain some recognition, and hopefully won't be remembered only for this nothingness of song.
Thank you so much. I loved and agreed with you entirely. Okay, you're always
whatever,
right.
Whatever, you're welcome. But who are you?
I'm just a fan of your videos.
What kind of fan would do this?
A desperate one. I admit that I may be acting kind of like a psycho right now. I'm sorry, but I come from a home where my opinions have been repressed. I'm not allowed to speak my mind because I'm only a child, and doing so means punishment. Then I discovered critics. People who not only give their opinions constantly, but are admired for it. I watched them whenever I could, and I found you, underrated, but yet so talented and intelligent.
Well, thank you.
Do a Toon Toons next.
What?
Your next video will be a Toon Toons. Until then, I will grant you electricity and freedom to leave your home. But when I come and call in, you better be ready to review.
Wait,
he's a Malacritico. There's a lot to choose from, but he's got to choose him. Always wanted to do that.